come to realize I need to take a little more action with my bug problem, and I do have an interesting solution. I'm not going to tell you why I discovered this because it might gross some people out, but apparently, welcome to week 6 of my indoor food gardening journey. There have been some absolutely disturbing events that have taken place so far this week in the indoor food garden. If you haven't guessed it from the thumbnail, there's a good clue as to what is going on in the thumbnail. Before we get right into the tour, I'm going to give you a little recap of what's been going on this week. You need that information before you see what's currently taking place. On a side note, it is currently... It's 9:45 in the morning, and I never film this late in the morning, so the lighting might be a little weird. Hopefully not, fingers crossed, but that is what we are dealing with. A little bit of a later time for filming. 3 days since I last gave you guys an update on my little indoor garden, and I haven't checked on them today. I'm back to work after a vacation, and there's something very disturbing going on in my little indoor garden. Let me show you. This is very bad news. We're going to take a little look at my basil plant. My basil plants have been doing super well since I brought them in from the summer, but this is very bad news. I think the camera is picking it up. I walked in here and it looks like it's covered in bug eggs. I know that these bugs have been flying around a bit, but really covered in eggs. Let's go into the light and take a closer look here. This is so disturbing. There are so many bug eggs on this plant. This is absolutely terrible. How could this happen? This is all one basil plant. Going to the neighboring basil plant, this one here, I think it has a few bug eggs on it. And thankfully, the two beside it, I have 4 plants here, 4 pots of basil. I think these two are still clean. So now my question is, what do I do with these? Do I have to pull them out? Should I scrub them? It's really sad that this happened, but what should I do about it? This one might get pulled out. I'm not happy about this, but I don't want a full infestation either. So gonna have to do something with these tonight. In the bathroom now with a heavily infested basil plant. I'm gonna see if I can scrub this. Might be a lost cause, but let's see if we can give it a little scrub, this little plant. I might end up tossing it by tomorrow morning, but we're gonna try to save it. This is what I would call rescue plant 911. 911 plant rescue right here. We are giving these guys, ooh, look at all those eggs. Giving them a thorough cleanse and seeing if this can save them. I'm not super optimistic though. I'm not optimistic this is gonna work, but we're giving it a try. Come to realize I need to take a little more action with my bug problem, and I do have an interesting solution. I'm not going to tell you why I discovered this because it might gross some people out, but apparently bugs don't like mouthwash. I'm not going to tell you the story as to how I discovered that because I'm pretty sure some viewers will be grossed out, but I have learned they don't like mouthwash, and this guy is everywhere I am. He can't stop following me around sometimes. So we are going to create a bug trap using mouthwash. Second thoughts, on second thoughts, I'm just gonna show you.
you're grossed out, don't pay attention to this. There's a bug right here. Earlier today, I discovered several bugs on this bottle. It's like they somehow got attracted to the mouthwash dripping down the side of it and never left the bottle after that. So I've learned it seems to be a bug trap solution.
So we're gonna pour some of that mouthwash into this cup, set it up in the plant room, and see what happens. Added it to my windowsill, not right beside the basil because I don't have a lot of space over there, but kind of just in the middle of everything else, and we'll see how many bugs this little trap catches. Good afternoon. It's been about 4 to 5 days since my last indoor garden update, and I have some devastating news to share with you. Coming a little further over in this same window where the tragedy struck the first pot, let's take a closer look at this seedling. It is really struggling. I'm a bit on the fence about whether or not I should pull this one out too. It's not looking rather good. I'm leaning towards saying a final goodbye to this bell pepper plant. I have so many, so why should I nurse it back to health? I think we're going to pull the plug and say our prayers for this little bell pepper plant. On a quick little happier note, check out the growth on the green onion. We'll get into that on the real tour, but needed to throw in something positive before I give you any more news that might not be super positive. Here's a quick look at the lettuce planter that started out doing really well and within about a week took a turn. I think we're going to be ruthless here and pull all but one of these seedlings out. We're going to clean it up and possibly use this for something else. The seedling here actually looks not bad. Gonna give it a bit more of a chance, but everything else is going to be removed. Since we just removed a bunch of plants, everything in me says you need to plant some seeds. So I have some new seeds, a new plant species we haven't been experimenting with yet in this indoor garden. A package of zucchini seeds, also known as courgettes or summer squash. This is a yellow variety. This was from the local Dollar Tree sometime in spring. Didn't actually plant them in the outdoor garden, so we're going to try them on the indoor garden. Totally experimental. Don't know if squash growing indoors is something that will be effective, but I have space now, so let's give it a try. And a supervisor came running when he heard me talking to the camera. He's investigating one of my DIY projects. So I'm going to be planting these zucchini seeds into that grow bag that I removed the lettuce from. Technically, I still have those two empty pots where I originally started the cucumber seedlings. But the cucumber seedlings are doing well, and soon they will go back to those pots, so we're just going to save them. We're going to use the grow bag, put 4 of these zucchini seeds in there, and if I get 4 that germinate, I will find a home for them. So let's open these seeds. There we go. I think I have 5 here, so we'll put 1 back. 4 seeds for my grow bag. Just gonna place them into the soil here, stick my finger in, and see what happens. You guys, I just could not wait to show you. It's still the day I planted the zucchini, and look at this. My little strawberry plant has a fresh flower. I am so excited. These we planted just last week. Good morning, everyone. It is early morning. I guess maybe 6 o'clock. Maybe it's been 5 days since I filmed. I can't even remember right now. But these are my green onions, and they're starting to get a bend in them. So to me, that says it's time to do a harvest. They have been super fast growing. So we're just going to harvest them and put them in my morning scrambled eggs. This is my first onion harvest from my indoor garden. And that should be plenty for my scrambled egg dish this morning. So we're gonna jump right into the tour now. Starting out with my green onions. I've already harvested from here, which I did film. Hopefully I didn't delete the clip. But I have done a little green onion harvest. So I have literally already ate from these green onions since they've been planted. I want to say that was 2 weeks ago I planted them. Definitely worth planting the roots of grocery store green onions. You can do this in soil or just a glass of water. Literally, they will grow. Best value for regrowing vegetables and so fast to grow right here in the form of green onions. Moving into the strawberry planter, we have super, super exciting developments happening here. You would have seen in the last video, this is where I transplanted those strawberries from outside. And we have our first flowers. And I think there's something else going on here that I just noticed with the zoom. We're going to talk about that in a second, but let's talk about the flowers first. There's one here. Let me zoom out. We've got coming over here. There are two more flowers over here. This is super exciting. I had seen there was a flower probably yesterday, but I didn't really look too close at the plant. And now I see there's actually three flowers. So we are going to do some hand pollination. The little supervisor just arrived to make sure that I'm doing the pollination techniques correctly. So I've got a Q-tip here and we're gonna see if we can do this by hand. Here's my Q-tip. We are just going to, first of all, let's zoom in into this little flower here. I'm just gonna rub it around all of these little, I don't even know what you call them, the inner part of the flower. Let's go nice and close and take my Q-tip, roll it around in this flower. Try to pretend we're bee. Let's pretend we're a bee right now. We're going to get up close and intimate with this flower, and then we're going to go and put the Q-tip in another flower right over here. Give it a nice smooth roll with this Q-tip before we go into the third flower right over here. Get some Q-tip action happening in this flower. Give it a good rub with the Q-tip. And I'm gonna do this a couple of times because maybe even more than that. Oh my God. Did you guys just see that? Because I did in the camera lens. I saw a good sized bug literally fly in that strawberry plant. And I had a feeling that's where my problems were coming from. I'm not too pleased about this. I thought I only had those little tiny bugs. I might have more bugs than I imagined. So back to the pollination. Let's do this one more time. Make sure these strawberry plants are adequately pollinated. So you saw here, this was not from outside. I just pollinated three flowers. So this video is evidence. If we, in a few weeks' time, start to see some new fruits developing, they were pollinated by me. So let's take a look at the rest of the garden. Here he is looking for something to get into. Back to my indoor food garden. So up until now, I have had absolutely no problems with any of my basil plants. They don't look too bad. If we see what's going on here, then we have another one here and another one here. However, I didn't show you what's going on with my fourth basil plant. It is currently being quarantined. After the video clip I would have showed you at the beginning of this video, this little basil plant is being quarantined in this little corner, not even in the window. I should probably move it somewhere else, but for now it's here. And I am giving some serious consideration to tossing that basil plant. However, I am a little bit up in the air about that because I hope that whatever bug has decided to replicate itself on my basil plant, I truly hope that it hasn't contaminated my other plants because I don't want to throw out all my basil plants. So I'm a little bit on the fence about that. I probably will end up composting that one because the three other ones are pretty good. I found a few culprits on one of my other basil plants, which I very thoroughly washed, got rid of as soon as possible, gave it a pruning. But that one particular one, I'm thinking it's toast. I don't want to think that, but those bugs are abundant. So let's continue the tour. Here we are back in the window. Okay. This is my lady lettuce planter that I've talked about, shown many times here. And I see a bug once again. It's doing okay. Probably better than it's been doing for a while. Still leggy, but I think it's improving slowly and surely. My second cucumber seedling, still slow growing, but just puttering along. And I think I filmed a video clip earlier in the week about my new form of bug trap. Well, what I thought was gonna work. It has only caught, it's capturing it. There is literally one bug. I thought it would have caught a lot more, but apparently not. This bug trap is catching them. So back into my little seed starting tray here. My bell peppers are doing pretty well. The tomatoes we've got here, 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 and at the back, they're just growing nice and slow as per usual. This tray is looking absolutely stunning. These bell pepper plants, this tomato plant, I'm thinking very shortly they're gonna need potting up. There's still some smaller tomato plants at the back, but overall, this one is on fire with growth. And my superstar right now is this cucumber plant. Look at that growth. Look how big this leaf is. I mean, if you compare it to my hand, it's not huge, but compared to the little tiny seedling over here, it is tremendously bigger, and they were started at the exact same time. So I have nothing but good things to say about this cucumber plant. I should probably start giving these guys over here some kind of a pep talk. Let me know in the comments if you've ever given your plants a pep talk. Honestly, I never have, but I'm starting to wonder if that would be a good thing. Like, put those positive vibes out there. Like, maybe even plants can pick up on positive energy. Who knows? I mean, plants are pretty amazing forms of life, so maybe they can even pick up on positive energy, negative energy, who knows? But let me know down below if you've ever talked to your plants, if you've ever sang to them or played music for them. I would love to know in the comments how many people have tried that and if you think it's actually benefited your plants. So I look forward to reading your responses. Now going to journey on top of the bed to check out this window up here. This is where I have a few bell pepper seedlings. And they're
doing pretty well up here. These ones were potted up, I want to say that was 2 to 3 weeks ago already. My memory is, time flies sometimes. And this one, doing quite well. This was the one in the only bell pepper plant that has drainage in the pot. The other ones have no drainage holes, but it's doing fairly well. And this window does not get a ton of natural light compared to the window over here. And this one too is also doing exceptionally well. I do occasionally rotate them under my grow lights, but overall, most of the light comes from the window right here, which is not that much. So no complaints about how these guys are going. They get, I'm gonna give them an A for their growth scores if we're gonna start a report card. And we are now standing on a stool to take an examination of the plants over here. They're doing fine. The two that are left, you would have seen earlier in the video that I did pull this one and this one out. I have not done anything with the pots yet. Probably will repurpose them. I don't think there's actually anything wrong with the soil as far as I know. I suspect the reason those two plants died was actually from my lack of watering. I had a few commenters suggest that I cut back on my watering, and I've significantly cut back on how much I've been watering these little seedlings, but I might have cut back too much on some of them. I think they dried out a little too much, and that's probably what brought them to their demise, a little bit of dehydration. So I'm gonna try to water a little more frequently. Hopefully we don't have too many more tragedies in the world of indoor food gardening. Here he is, just chilling out, waiting for his morning walk. We are going to go right after this video. Thank you for watching week 6 in my indoor food gardening journey. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe so you don't miss future indoor gardening updates. And let me know in the comments if you've ever started an indoor food garden or grown any food inside your house during the winter. I'm hoping that this series inspires at least one person in the world to try growing a little food inside their home in the winter time. I hope you are having a lovely day, evening, or night wherever you are. And we will see you very soon with another video. Bye for now.